to thank you very much for coming. I'm Ken Wallach. I'm president of NDI and the National Endowment for Democracy, and NDI is very proud and honored to host Tawakkol here. She has hosted NDI in her tent on Change Square many, many times. It's like a second home for us, and so we are very pleased that we could provide a little bit of hospitality to you in our tent. I will just say a few words, and then I'm going to turn this over to Carl Gershman, who's president of the National Endowment for Democracy, and he'll give some remarks. And then Les Campbell, NDI's Middle East Director, who has been on the Washington Sana'a shuttle now for the past 3 or 4 years in an effort to try to negotiate between the government, between the president and the opposition on political reform. An extraordinary effort over the past several years. I'd just like to make a few points, if I could, and Tawakkol can correct me for any mistakes that I may make. But I think recent events in Yemen are often couched in the context of the Arab Spring, when in fact that political and civic activists like Tawakkol have been at the vanguard for calls for democratic reform over the past 5 or 6 years. That Yemen has a history and a tradition of dialogue makes the recent crisis that much more of a tragedy. Yemen has had all the elements of a country in which one would have hoped that a peaceful negotiated transition could have taken place, a multi-party system, some competitive elections, an active civil society of very, very talented people, a media that up until about 18 months ago was fairly open, and the active participation of women in civic and political life. And even now, in the midst of the crisis and the ongoing unrest and the violence, the political parties and civic activists and demonstrators in protest squares across the country are calling for a transition process that is consistent with Yemen's laws and constitution. And their calls are those of a modern democratic state. And while Yemenis are understandably worried about the future of their country, and it faces an uphill struggle to overcome its many challenges, we continue to be optimistic that those institutions that remain intact, those individuals and those organizations that existed before the crisis, will provide the potential for Yemen to come through to an eventual transition and avoid becoming the failed state that some analysts predict. For 18 years, NDI has worked in Yemen to support the development of an inclusive political system. We have been proud to work with Tawakkol since, I believe, 2006, when Robin Madrid, where's Robin? Robin Madrid was our director in Yemen, and she and Tawakkol discovered each other. And we have been proud to work with so many politicians and civic activists. And this is a country that, as many of you know, you quickly fall in love with. And it's like malaria, it follows you everywhere. And it is a wonderful, wonderful place with extraordinary people. And Yemen has many friends around the world, and I can only say that Tawakkol is an extraordinary representative of those people. So I want to thank you for joining us. And with that, I'll turn it to Carl.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ken. I only met Tawakkol on the start of this week, but she's been a grantee of the NEDS with her organization, Women Journalists Without Chains, for 5 years. And she was a participant in Jakarta in April of 2010 at the World Movement for Democracy, and is part of a global network of activists which, when she got in trouble, provided support and solidarity for her to help her get out of jail. I have been impressed with how she has conveyed her message this week. I took her in to see Speaker Boehner on Monday. She met this morning with Secretary Clinton. She's met with a lot of members of Congress, a lot of staffers. There's a report in the Washington Post this morning about her interview with the Washington Post, Jackson Deal. And we've all been impressed by how focused she is on conveying her message, having to do with accountability, having to do with democracy as the only real way, in the end, to combat al-Qaeda and terrorism. The need for accountability for the leaders, and then also the need for nonviolence and international solidarity. When you get to know Tawakkol and hear her message, you realize how absolutely essential it is to provide this international solidarity for a cause that is just and a cause that is being carried out non-violently and in a manner consistent with democratic values. This is a very important struggle. I believe it's going to prevail in the end. It's only a matter of time. And the sooner it prevails, the better it will be for the future of the Middle East.
Is Kim? Les, Kim talking? Okay.
Go ahead. Well, I'm not going to talk so much as I wanted to throw it open to Tawakkol. Maybe I'll just throw out a question or at least a comment that maybe she'll respond to, which is that I think when you read the coverage or watch the television coverage of what's going on in Yemen, it's portrayed almost always as exclusively a negotiation among the president and sort of the people surrounding him, the opposition parties, and there's an opposition coalition called the Joint Meeting Parties, or JMP. And then a group of internationals that include the GCC countries, Saudi Arabia, and so on. And if you follow the news coverage a little bit over the last few months, it's just sort of a soap opera. Will the president sign some sort of agreement? Won't he sign the agreement? As many of you know, there was a bomb attack in the president's mosque, and he and a number of people were injured. Surprisingly, I thought, and a testament to the enduring strength of some of the institutions in Yemen, there was no political transition, even though the president and most of the senior government colleagues were wounded and out of the country for a long time. But in the meantime, this sort of dance about will they or won't they sign went on and on. In my opinion, and I throw this out for Tawakkol to see what she thinks, in my opinion, the whole exercise has become increasingly farcical because it's not clear that signing a piece of paper is somehow going to create this change. In other words, if the occupation of so many of the centers of so many cities in Yemen, the deaths of dozens and dozens, hundreds of people by now, the almost assassination of the president and the serious wounding of many of his colleagues, if this hasn't led to a transition or a change, then I think signing a document, which by now also has all sorts of funny little amendments and details and so on, seems to kind of miss the whole point. But in the meantime, and I think what doesn't get reported as much, except you just see the pictures of it, is the amazing mobilization of people, what people sometimes call the youth in shorthand. Although in Yemen this might be a very broad term, because the people that are on the square, some of them are very young, a lot of them are university students, but many of them are older, or they come from all walks of life. But they have been amazingly consistent and amazingly persistent. In Sana'a for sure, where Tawakkol spends a lot of time in her tent, but also in Taiz, which is another major city where the protests have actually been, generally speaking, been larger and more persistent, have been I think more consistent in terms of their demands and so on. So it's not a question, but it's more of a comment, which I hope Tawakkol will respond to, is what are the demands, forget, just putting aside for a second the JMP, the formal opposition coalition, putting aside the GCC agreement, which, you know, increasingly is a discussion that just happens among ambassadors, and putting aside even the tribal leaders like the Al-Akhmar family, what has the youth movement, what have the protesters proposed? What is their plan? What's their transition plan? And how would, I'd like to know how Tawakkol envisions the political transition happening, because all of the other means, all of the other negotiations have thus far shown, have not had any results. So I wonder what she thinks, or what she would propose, or what she would advocate be the next steps to actually cause some sort of change in Yemen, so that we can get away from this very, very dangerous downward cycle and move on to something more positive.
Okay. Thank you for all. And sorry, I will speak in Arabic because I want to be more clear, if you don't mind. أنا لن أتحدث كثيراً حول الثورة الشبابية السلمية في اليمن لأنه حسب معرفتي بأن أغلب الموجودين هنا مهتمين بالشأن اليمني ويعلمون كثيراً عن هذه الثورة.
I will not. Can does this work? You can hear me. Yeah. Okay.
Thank I will not talk at length about the youth, the peaceful youth revolution in Yemen, because most of you here are very well versed about what's happening in Yemen and are aware of the latest developments there.
لكن سأقول بأنه الثورة الشبابية السلمية هي جاءت حل لكافة الصراعات التي كانت تعانيها اليمن قبل الثورة.
But I will say that the peaceful revolution in Yemen has come as a solution to all the struggles that existed in Yemen at all levels.
شباب الثورة ملوا الأزمة السياسية التي كانت بين الحزب الحاكم وبين المعارضة والتي دامت لسنين وصلت إلى قطيعة حقيقية.
The youth of the revolution have grown tired of the political crisis that existed between the ruling party and the opposition, which has reached a very critical stage.
وقفوا بجدية أمام الحروب الستة التي كانت تعاني منها صعدة خلال أربع سنوات من الحرب.
And they have taken a serious stand against the wars that raged on in Saada during the last 4 years. And also in the face of demands for separation in the south.
كانت هناك حركات احتجاجات واسعة قبل الثورة يقودها نشطاء مدنيين وصحفيين تطالب بالحقوق والحريات وتناهض الفساد.
There were widespread protests in Yemen even before the revolution. By civil activists who demanded freedoms and change in Yemen.
ولكن الوضع كان يزداد سوء. الحقوق والحريات تزداد تدهور. الفساد يزداد انتشار والحروب تزداد وكذلك الإرهاب.
But the situation was getting worse in Yemen, and there was a serious regression in rights, and corruption was widespread, and wars and terrorism was also on the rise.
بمعنى كان هناك تمنع من قبل نظام صالح من الاستجابة لكافة المطالب سواء التي طالب بها أحزاب المعارضة أو الذي يطالب بها النشطاء المدنيين والصحفيين.
Which means that the Saleh regime was totally blind and to all the demands of the opposition and also the civil rights activists.
فما الذي جاء الحل؟ الحل هو يعني بعد ثورة تونس الذي جاءت بشعار يلبي طموحاتنا ومطالبنا للتغيير الذي كنا طيلة خمس سنوات نادي به وهو أن الشعب يريد إسقاط النظام.
So the solution came right after the revolution in Tunis, which had the slogan that basically satisfied our aspirations, and that is to bring the regime down.
وإقامة نظام بديل قائم على المواطنة المتساوية, قائم على احترام حقوق الإنسان, قائم على معايير الحكم الرشيد, نظام يقود إلى دولة, يعني يعمل على تأسيس الدولة المدنية الحديثة الديمقراطية.
And also to establish a regime that respects human rights and the rights of everyone, and also that observes the principles of good governance and builds a new civil and modern state.
فبدأ الشباب بدون إذن من أحد قاموا بهذه الثورة على الرغم من أنه كان هناك رفض لهذا الخيار, وكانت هناك من يقول بأنه هذه الثورة لن تستمر شهر وأن اليمن ستدخل في حروب لا طائل لها إن تم تبني الثورة.
The young people in Yemen have launched this revolution without any permission from anyone, despite the rejection that they were faced with, and the naysayers who said that this will lead to wars that they would not, never-ending wars in Yemen.
وقلنا لهم بأنكم سترون بأن كل هذه الصراعات اللي أنتم تتحدثوا عنها, كل هذه الإشكالات, أن الثورة الشبابية السلمية قادرة على تحييدها, أن جميع اليمن بحراكها الحراك والحوثيين والأحزاب والجيش والقبائل والشباب ومنظمات المجتمع المدني كلهم سيكونون أو سيتوحدوا تحت مطلب أن الشعب يريد إسقاط النظام.
And we told them that all these struggles and dilemmas will be resolved by the revolution, which will be able to kind of unite everyone, whether it was the Houthis or the army or the tribes or the young people or the NGOs, and they will all be able to come together under the slogan of let's bring the regime down.
وهذا ما حصل.
And this is exactly what happened.
في تاريخ اليمن المعاصر هذه أول مرحلة يعيش فيها اليمنيين كلهم تحت مظلة واحدة يريدون إسقاط النظام ويعني تغيير النظام وبناء الدولة المدنية الحديثة.
And this is the first time in Yemen that such a thing happens, that all these forces come together under one umbrella to bring the regime down, and they're all united again by the slogan let's bring the regime down.
بل إن كثير من المشاكل التي تعتبر يجب أنها تحقق أنها عبرها أهداف الثورة أنه حققت قبل الانتصار النهائي.
And even several problems that the revolution was supposed to resolve have been already resolved before the revolution comes to an end.
على سبيل المثال حرب صعدة توقفت تماما.
For example, the war in Saada has stopped completely.
على سبيل المثال الثارات بين القبائل توقفت تماما.
Another example is the vendettas between the different tribes have completely ceased.
بل إنه القبائل الآن المتناحرة والتي بينها مئات القتلى الآن تعيش داخل خيمة واحدة تأكل وتشرب وتنام في نفس الخيمة, بينما كانوا قبل الثورة لا يجرؤ أحد أن يقترب من أن يرى أن ينظر إليه أي أحد من القبيلة الأخرى لأنه سوف يقتل.
Even warring tribes, you know, who have vendettas against each other, have now come together under one tent. When in the past they did not even dare to come close to each other because of existing wars between
them. حتى على صعيد المشاركة السياسية للمرأة التي كنا ننادي بها, يعني المشاركة السياسية للمرأة الآن أصبحت المرأة قائدة حقيقية, تحولت من مجرد ضحية, من مجرد صاحبة دور تقليدي في المنزل أو وظيفة تقليدية, الآن أصبحت قائدة وصاحبة فعل كبير في إسقاط النظام وفي كذلك في بناء الدولة المدنية الحديثة التي يريدها.
Even women, the political participation of women has increased, and women have moved from their traditional role as also a victim in society, and now they are real leaders who are playing a major role in changing the regime and their society.
مطالب حتى الانفصال انحسرت وتراجعت, والآن تجد أصوات في الجنوب كثير منها كثير من شباب الجنوب يرفعون علم اليمن ويقفون للنشيد الوطني ويحلمون بأن نبني مع بعض الدولة التي نريدها.
Even calls for secession that existed in the south have receded now, and now you see that people in southern Yemen are raising the Yemeni flag and also calling for change throughout Yemen.
واخيرا الارهاب والقاعده طيله 9 اشهر لم تجد او لم يسمع العالم عن حاله حقيقيه او استهداف حقيقي من القاعده على عكس ما كان قبل الثوره.
And last but not least, with respect to terrorism and Al-Qaeda, over 9 months, we have not heard a single case in which Al-Qaeda has launched any attack. And to the contrary, I mean, it's been very peaceful.
وبالتالي الثورة السلمية الشبابية السلمية التي يقودها الشباب وتقودها النساء جاءت مخرج لكثير من القضايا التي كان يعاني منها اليمن قبل الثورة.
Hence, the peaceful youth revolution in Yemen has offered a way out of several of the problems that Yemen suffered from before the revolution.
الآن ما الذي يواجه هذه الثورة؟
Now, what issues confront this revolution?
هذه الثورة حققت كثير من أهدافها وحققت كذلك إسقاط شرعية ومشروعية نظام صالح. هذا الرجل الآن لا يعد له
This revolution has achieved several of its goals, and most importantly, it has undermined the legitimacy of President Saleh, and now he has no legitimacy throughout Yemen.
وعلي صالح لا يحكم الآن اليمن كحاكم ولن يحكمها مستقبل لا هو ولا أولاده.
And now Ali Saleh does not rule Yemen as its leader. And neither he nor his children will rule it in the future.
وهو فعليا فاقد السيطرة في جميع محافظات الجمهورية.
And in reality, he has lost control over all parts of Yemen.
هو فقط مسيطر على جزء من صنعاء ومسيطر عليها بقوة السلاح.
He only controls a part of Sana'a and with the threat of force.
والثاني والأمر الثاني الذي يواجه الشباب الثورة الشبابية الشعبية. ويستقوي به علي صالح هو عدم وجود موقف واضح وصريح تجاه نظام صالح وجرائم صالح.
And the second issue that is facing the revolution and that is strengthening Saleh's position vis-a-vis the revolution is the absence of a clear international position vis-a-vis what's happening in Yemen.
علي صالح يمارس القتل بشكل يومي كرئيس كمجرم وليس كرئيس دولة.
Ali Saleh is engaged in daily killings in Yemen as a murderer, not as a president.
هو بيقتل بشكل يومي هناك ما لا يقل الآن عن 1000 شهيد قتلوا داخل الساحات هذا غير الذين داخل الساحات وهم يتظاهر متظاهر يعني 1000 متظاهر سلمي قتلوا في الساحات.
Inside the squares, Ali Saleh has killed 1,000 martyrs, and these were peaceful demonstrators.
20,000 جريح معاق إعاقة شديدة نتيجة استهداف علي صالح له واستخدامه القوة المفرطة والأسلحة الثقيلة في مواجهة المتظاهرين السلميين.
And there are 20,000 people who have been wounded, and some of them with serious disabilities. And this has been the result of Ali Saleh's targeting of these demonstrators with the use of force and heavy artillery.
الشباب والشعب اليمني الذي يمتلك 70 مليون قطعة سلاح تركها جانبا وخرج إلى الساحات بالملايين يستقبل كل هذا العنف بصدوره العالية.
The youth and the people who we know that in Yemen there are like 70 million pieces of weaponry. They have left all this aside, and now they're facing the oppression of the regime, bare-chested, without any the use of arms. And they've been living under the bare sky, you know, in the cold, and for the last 9 months, seeking their freedom and their rights. And they cannot take any steps back.
ولا يمكن أن يتوقفوا.
And they will not stop.
نحن سنفوز في معركتنا معركة الحرية والعدالة والكرامة التي اخترناها. المعركه السلميه من اجل الحريه والحد والعداله والكرامه التي اخترناها.
And we will win this war for freedom and justice and pride that we have and that we have launched.
لكن للأسف كما قال الأخ ليس كامبل بأن هناك مهزلة في التعامل مع الثورة اليمنية.
But unfortunately, as Brother Les Campbell has pointed out, there is the way that the Yemeni crisis is being dealt with is a joke.
هذه المهزلة من قبل المجتمع الدولي ومن قبل المبادرة الخليجية التي منحت علي صالح ضمانات وحصانات من المساءلة والعقاب تجاه جرائمه وتجاه إساءة استغلال السلطة تجاه جرائم الفساد التي ارتكبها.
And the international community and the also the Gulf Cooperation Council's initiative, they offer Saleh guarantees against being tried for and being held accountable for the murders and also the corruption that he's been engaged in.
هذا ما نصت عليه المبادرة الخليجية.
This was this is what the Gulf Cooperation Council's initiative provided for.
هذا غير أن المبادرة الخليجية تحدثت عن أزمة بين السلطة والمعارضة.
Not to mention that the initiative talks about a crisis between the regime and the opposition.
وكأن الشباب غير موجود وكأنه لا يوجد هناك شهداء وجرحى أغلبهم تحت سن 25.
As though the youth are not there and as though there hasn't been any haven't been any martyrs and no one was killed.
وهذا أمر مرفوض عشان كذا شباب الثورة يرفضون هذه المبادرة لهذا الشيئين منحها ضمانات وحصان العلي صالح من المساءلة على جرائم الفساد وجرائم القتل والاعتبارها الثورة اليمنية مجرد أزمة بين السلطة والمعارضة.
And this is something we reject. And so we basically reject the GCC initiative for two reasons. First, it offers Ali Abdullah Saleh guarantees and immunity against being held accountable for his crimes. And also, the second point is because it considers what's happening in Yemen as a crisis.
ومع ذلك نحن قلنا للمعارضة وقلنا للدول الخليجية وقلنا للمجتمع الدولي. هذه مبادرة لا تعنينا. شباب الثورة يرفضوها. أنتم إذا متبنينها خلوه يوقع.
And in spite of that, we told the opposition and the GCC and also the international community that we are not interested in this initiative, and told them that if you are interested in it, let Ali Abdullah Saleh sign it.
وهو لن يوقع.
And he will not sign it.
وكلمناهم منذ مايو وقبل مايو وهناك المبادرة عدة مرات. علي صالح لن يوقع.
And we have talked to them several times since May and before May, and we continue to say that Ali Saleh will not sign it.
علي صالح فقط سيستغل الوقت لقتل المواطنين ولكي يحبط الثورة الشبابية.
Ali Saleh will kind of use this time to continue to kill the people and to thwart the revolution.
وهذا ما فعل.
And this is exactly what he's done.
تحت مظلة المبادرة الخليجية ومظلة الضمانات استمر بالقتل كل يوم أزيد من اليوم الذي قبله.
And under the umbrella of the GCC initiative and the guarantees that it offers him, he continued to kill people. And his actions even intensified.
منذ مايو منذ أن وقعت المعارضة والحزب الحاكم على المبادرة معدل القتل الذي قام به على صار 9 أضعاف ما كان قبل الثورة.
So since May and since the opposition and the ruling party signed the agreement, the rate of killing in Yemen has increased by 9%. 9 times, I'm sorry.
عموما نحن شباب الثورة مستمرين والشعب اليمني كله مش فقط الشباب جميعهم مصمم على أنه هذه الثورة ستحقق أهدافها كاملة.
But in general, we and the youth of the revolution and also all Yemenis are determined to continue this revolution until we achieve all our goals.
وبطريقة سلمية لن ننجر للعنف الذي يريده علي صالح.
And in a peaceful manner, and we will not resort to the violence that Ali Abdullah Saleh is trying to push us into. And we are ready and willing to die for our freedom and our pride and also the modern civil state that we would like to establish.
الحاصل أو ما نريده بأنه هناك طلبين أساسيين.
Now what is happening or what we really want are two main demands.
إذا يريد أصدقائنا في في الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية وفي المجتمع الدولي أنه عليهم أن يعلموا أن الشباب وأن التغيير هو المستقبل.
Our friends in the U.S. and the international community should know that for us, the youth change is the future. And they have to support our demands. Our demands are not difficult. And it's no less than what the international community has done in support of the revolutions in Tunisia and Egypt and Libya.
طلبين لا غير. واحد تجميد أمواله التي يشتري عبرها الأسلحة ويقتل بها الناس ويشتري بها كذلك الشبيحة والبلاطجة والقناص الذي يقتل بها المتظاهرين.
There are two demands. First, to freeze his assets, which he uses to buy weapons and also people and the thugs that he kind of unleashes against the people and to kill them.
الطلب الثاني وهو إحالة ملفه إلى محكمة الجنايات الدولية.
And the second demand is to refer him to the International Court of Justice.
لأنه يمارس القتل بحق المتظاهرين السنيين.
Because he's killing defenseless and innocent peaceful protesters.
مش هنتكلم عن بقية الجرائم على الأقل على هذه الجريمة.
We will not talk about the other crimes he's been engaged in. Let's at least focus on this one, and his crimes are many. And this is important.
Ali Saleh لن يوقع على شيء.
And it's important to mention that Ali Saleh will not sign anything.
وإذا وقع وفق يعني لحظة ربما يتخذها وأنا أشك في ذلك لكنه لن ينفذ شيء.
And even if he were to sign, maybe in a decision he takes on the spur of the moment, we are certain that he will not execute any of those stipulations.
نفس الوقت الذي ضيعه من أجل التوقيع للمبادرة سيضيع أضعافه وسنين من أجل تنفيذ ما وقع عليه.
The same time he has taken to sign the agreement, he will waste even greater time implementing its provisions.
أنا لا أريد أن أتحدث عن شخص علي صالح لأنه لا توجد لدينا مشكلة مع شخصه.
I don't want to talk about the person of Ali Abdullah Saleh. We don't have any issues with his person.
هو لديه شيئين في شخصيته وأعتقد الجميع يعرفوا. واحد هو مراوغ وخادع والشيء الثاني أنه جبان.
His personality has two main characters. First of all, he's a very deceptive person. And the second thing is that he is also a coward. The world has discovered how much he stole through his actions when he was trying to sign. And he has not signed up until now.
يحال ملفه إلى محكمة الجنايات الدولية كيف أنه سيوقع غصبا عنه.
And the world will discover that when his assets are frozen and he's referred to the International Court of Justice, he will sign.
أخيرا بالنسبة لما قالوا ما المشروع البديل.
Lastly, I'd like to address the issue of the alternative plan.
نحن كشباب الثورة حين بدأنا هذه الثورة كان يقال لنا في البداية إنه من بعد علي صالح كنا نقول لهم نحن لا نسأل عن هذا الشيء نحن نريد أول شيء تغيير نظام علي صالح ومن ثم اسألونا من بعد علي صالح.
We, the youth, when we started this revolution, we used to be asked what will come after Ali Abdullah Saleh, and we used to say we're not going to discuss this issue. We'll wait until we change the regime. And we firmly believe that Ali Abdullah Saleh and his legitimacy is over. And he actually says that. He says that he will leave very soon. So who will come after Ali Abdullah Saleh? We have the alternative. The youth movement, we announced on July 16 the creation of the Transitional Presidential Council. And of course, we announced this after Ali Abdullah Saleh was targeted and he left for Saudi Arabia. And this council is comprised of 17 members, and they all have consensus, and they're well known inside and outside Yemen. And the members of this council were selected carefully, and they have good relations inside and outside Yemen, also in the US and with the European Union and other parties. And the opposition has also formed the National Council for Revolutionary Forces. And what we're currently working on is to make sure that this council will become the transitional parliament. And what we're doing and working on with our partners is to gain recognition for these two institutions so that they can play a role in the future. And also to expand these councils and also make some modifications so that they gain greater recognition inside and outside Yemen. This is what the project of the revolutionary youth. And this is their strategy to run the affairs of the country in the transitional period. Both councils will run the country until elections can be held. And both councils will work together in order to formulate or put down a new constitution for the modern state that is based on federalism.
سيعملوا على إقامة حوار وطني واسع بين جميع القوى لحل المشاكل التي تعاني منها اليمن وعلى رأسها القضية الجنوبية.
And both councils will hold a broad national dialogue to address all issues that the country suffers from, especially the situation in the south.
نحن الآن نفكر بجدية ونعمل على بناء بلدنا المدني والديمقراطي الذي ثرنا لأجله.
And now we are thinking of taking this very seriously and working to build our democratic country that we've been dreaming of.
عليكم أن تعملوا معنا من أجل أن تكونوا شركاء مع المستقبل، شركاء في اليمن من أجل البدء في هذه المرحلة.
And you have to work with us so that you can be partners with us for the future and support our efforts to build this new Yemen.
والمهم أن نعمل معاً من أجل تحقيق تجميد أصلة صالح وإحالته إلى محكمة الجنايات الدولية.
And it's important that we work together in order to freeze the assets of Saleh and also make sure he's referred to the International Court of Justice.
وأي اقتراحات من أجل التثبيت اللي هو العمل من أجل المجلس الرئاسي الانتقالي أو الوطني الانتقالي فنحن مرحبين بها لكننا لن نتوقف.
And any suggestions you have for consolidating the Presidential Council and the National Transitional Council are welcome, but we will not stop here.
Thank you very much.
If I can, we'll probably have time for questions and comments too, but I want to ask a, I mean, I think this is a wonderful, obviously I didn't need to ask questions because you were ready to lay out the entire thing from A to Z, and that's great. But maybe I'll try to ask, I think, the tough question. The last time that I was in Sana'a, we sat together, this was in June, in your tent in Cham Square, and you talked about the idea of a presidency council, the idea of a transitional council with other youth members as well. And at the time, and I still feel this way, I think it was a good idea. I still think it's a good idea. It was necessary to propose an alternative. You know, it's absolutely necessary if you're going to ask for this kind of radical change to reassure people about what comes next. And at the time, I think we were discussing the Libyan Transitional Council, and it obviously has had a lot of success in putting itself forward as an alternative and eventually gaining recognition, and that gave people, including NATO, the confidence to move forward. But since we had the conversation, and I congratulate you and the other youth for moving forward, and I know that you've named or that you've consulted with, you've drawn in a lot of very credible people, important people in Yemen, people with credibility who have agreed to serve on these two councils. But since that time, and here's my question, is the government of Yemen, or the regime of President Saleh, as you probably would prefer to refer it, has not fallen. There has not been this transition. It has, for whatever reason, proven to be amazingly resilient. The regime in Yemen has been able to absorb incredible shocks, economic shocks, violence, the defection of a large part of the army and important commanders. It's lost control, as you mentioned, of swaths of the country. And yet, it still has some kind of basis for surviving. There's still something there. There's some kind of institutional. I know it's a weird word to use in terms of Yemen, because a lot of people think that Yemen doesn't have institutions, but it does have institutions. And there's something important about the president, about his family, about the ruling party. They're about, obviously, the tribal system. Yemen is, to a large extent, reverting to a form of governance that has a lot more reliance on traditional forces, tribal forces. So I guess my question for you, Tawakkol, would be, and I'll speak for myself, but I suspect that a lot of people around the table feel the same way. You're laying out a perfectly logical transitional plan. It's got some relevance based on recent events in other countries. It should be possible to force the leader of the country out. We saw it happen in Egypt, we saw it happen in Tunisia peacefully. We saw it in Libya, where a leader was forced out violently, but where he was delegitimized by losing whatever allies he had and so on. But none of these things have happened in Yemen. And President Saleh, unlike, for example, Gaddafi, has allies, strong allies, who are not abandoning him. And he maintains some control, and as I mentioned before, which I still think is amazing, was able to leave the country for months and then come back and still and kind of almost resume where he left off. So I guess my question for you is, and this maybe relates to what the UN representative Jamal Ben Omar has been trying to do over the last couple of months as well, is I know you said the ICC and freezing of the assets, and that would have impact, I agree, but is there something else short of that that would be a catalyst for the kind of change you're seeking? You know, is there another event? I agree, the President Saleh is not going to sign the agreement, but is there something else, some other type of agreement, some other kind of event, an initiative that could be undertaken to move this along? Because otherwise, it seems to me, this could continue for many, many more months in the future.
I
want to clarify
that
I would like to point out that unfortunately there might be some mistakes or some things that are not clearly conveyed to the international community and our allies.
علي صالح واقعه ووجوده في البلد مرتبط بالقوة التي يعتمد عليها بالأسلحة التي لديه.
Ali Saleh's presence in the country is very closely related to his ability to use power and force in the country.
لكن مجتمعيا المؤسسات القبائل هو مرفوض تماما من الجميع.
But socially speaking, I mean, and also with the institutions and the tribes, he is totally he has total opposition.
لماذا لم يسقط علي صالح بالشكل الذي يفترض فيه كما سقط بن علي ومبارك؟
Why didn't Ali Saleh lose control or get driven out of power the way that Ben Ali was ousted in Tunis?
على الرغم من أن الثورة شاملة على ثورة حقيقية شملت المجتمع كله كل المحافظات على غير مثلا ما كان في تونس وفي مصر وفي مصر.
In spite of the fact that the revolution in Yemen has been comprehensive and it has covered all the provinces, unlike what happened, for example, in Tunis and also in Egypt. The problem lies in the absence of clarity in the international position from Ali Saleh.
بن علي ومبارك مجرد ما بدأ ظواهر السقوط أعلن عن أرصدتهم وجمدت.
With respect to Ben Ali, Mubarak, and also Al-Qaddafi, as soon as the revolution started, their assets were frozen. Until now, the assets of Ali Saleh have not been declared, let alone frozen.
Ali Saleh يمارس القتل بشكل يومي حتى الآن لم يعلن عن تشكيل لجنة تحقيق دولية بحقه.
Ali Saleh is engaged in daily killings of people, and up until now, there's no investigative committee that has been formed.
Ali Saleh ماسك موضوع القاعدة ويخوف المجتمع الدولي به.
Ali Saleh is using Al-Qaeda as a means to threaten and frighten the international community.
بينما هو المصدر الدعم الأول للقاعدة في اليمن.
When he is the main supporter of Al-Qaeda in Yemen.
وبالتالي المطلوب الآن كما قلت بأنه إذا تريد أن يعني إنه التغيير الديرالاتيكي أو السقوط لما نقول علي صالح وليس للدولة لأن مؤسسات الدولة ستبقى كما هي.
And therefore, when we say now, what we're trying to do is to oust Ali Saleh himself. Not, I would not say the state and the institutions of the state because they will continue to exist.
عندكم علي صالح إنه إذا تم الضغط عليه فسترون ذلك السقوط.
If there's pressure exerted on Ali Saleh, you will see him fall.
بالنسبة لي هل هناك مبادرات أو اتفاقيات ممكن تطرح كبديل؟ أنا أقول لا اتفاق ولا مبادرة ممكن ترغم علي صالح على الرحيل.
With respect to the question, are there initiatives or agreements that could be proposed or put on the table? I would say there is no such thing that will force Ali Abdullah Saleh to leave.
بل بالعكس توفر له مساحة جديدة للمراغمة.
Rather, on the contrary, it will offer him in more space to continue to stall.
الحل هو في دعم الخطة الانتقالية والتي تدعم بأنه هناك مؤسسات يجب مؤسسات الدولة لفترة انتقالية يجب أن تشكل وأن علي صالح يجب أن يعامل ك يعني غير شرعي وكرئيس عصابة.
And the solution lies in supporting the transitional plan and that
militia.
Institutions of the state should be formed, and rather that Ali Saleh should be treated as an illegitimate head of a militia or a gangster.
هذه هي المبادرة الوحيدة التي سترغمه والتي ستجعل يعني فرب نهايته.
This would be the only initiative that will force him to leave and will end this situation.
Why don't we do this? I know Tawakkol has to wrap up by 1:45, but why don't we?
أنا أريد عفواً بس أكد على شيء.
I'd like to stress one point.
إنه أيضاً اللي يساعد علي صالح على إنه يستمر بتلك يعني في اختطافه للسلطة أو في اغتصابه للسلطة هو الدعم السعودي له وهو السماح له بأن يعني يلقي خطابات من السعودية على الرغم من إنه خرج منها.
I'd like to stress one more point that what really helped Ali Saleh to in continuing to usurp power is the Saudi support that he gets and him being allowed to make statements from even when he was in Saudi Arabia.
والسؤال لماذا السؤال إنه لماذا خلال غياب 3 أشهر من علي صالح بإنه لم يكن هناك فعل حقيقي الميدان للأسف الشديد إنه أحزاب المعارضة مقيدة بمبادرة الخليج التي وقعت عليها.
And the question is why hasn't there been any real action during his 3 months of absence? And the sad truth is that the opposition is tied up and constrained by the GCC initiative that it had signed.
فهم منتظرين الحل من علي صالح.
Therefore, they're waiting for the solution from Ali Saleh.
منتظرين إنه يوقع على أساس تنتقل السلطة إلى النائب.
And now they're waiting for him to sign the agreement so that he could transfer power to his deputy. And what we're saying is that this is useless talk. We are a peaceful youth revolution that wants to establish a democratic civil system based on real democracy.
وهذا لن يتأتي إلا بوجود البديل الحقيقي الديمقراطي والخالي من الفساد والبديل الذي يجمع عليه الشعب.
And this can only be accomplished through the presence of a real democratic alternative that the youth all agree to.
وهذا عبر مؤسسات الدولة الانتقالية.
And this can be achieved through the state's transitional institutions.
وما نحن مصرين عليه.
And this is what we insist on.
وما اقتنعت به المعارضة مؤخرا.
And this is also what the opposition has bought into lately.
With your permission, Tawakkol, why don't we do this? We'll go around, gather up a couple of questions, and then have you as sort of your finale respond to the questions, if that's okay. And then you can, that way you can control the time and wrap this up when you need to. So why don't we open up, just introduce yourselves quickly, and we'll gather up 2 or 3 questions. Laura?
Thanks. Laura Schultz from USA Today. My question relates to your comments about the unity behind this revolution and the fact that it's cutting across tribal allegiances, geographic divisions, political allegiances, and the like. If there is a transition and Saleh leaves power and there's a new government to be formed, how likely do you think that this unity will be able to hold? And what, along the same lines, what are some of the key differences or fault lines that you see in terms of how Yemenis are defining a vision for the future in a potential
First of all, I want to say congratulations on having the prize. Something you regard as given to all of the youth who have revolted against these regimes for the cause of freedom and democracy, but it's also a testament to your leadership and courage. We all want to acknowledge that. Um,
What do the people that you represent, the Youth Revolution, what do they think about President Obama's stance when it comes to Ali Abdullah Saleh? Is there a sense of disappointment that he can be so forthright about President Mubarak or Gaddafi, or even now finding President Assad in not taking a position, the same kind of position Ali Abdullah Saleh?
Thank you so much for your comments, for the clarity with which you speak. My question concerns one of the comments you made at the very end about Saudi Arabia. Because it strikes me that the Saudis actually are in many ways critical to your efforts or to any attempts to get Saleh Deen. Could you talk a little bit more about what kinds of measures you would suggest be taken, perhaps to pressure the Saudis, or how you see the Saudi role and an ability for them to play a more constructive role with respect to Yemen in the future?
There are two more, then we'll wrap up and allow Tawakkol to conclude across the circle.
I'm Elizabeth Marcus from Center for American Progress. My question is related to women's role in this revolution. I want to know, are women safe in the protest environment right now? Is it a safe place for women to be? And related to that, has there been an increase in violence against women that came along with the uprising?
These are a lot of questions, sir.
Yeah,
okay. I'll just, because you'll wrap up, I just want to add my voice in, and I know the people that spoke said they were proud. I think we're all proud to be associated with you, so you should.
Thank you.
And you should know that.
Yeah, thank you.
And so I know you'll have to run out, but you've got a lot of questions, but the floor is yours.
I
want to
reply to all. Okay. بالنسبة لي سؤال أول من لورا. نعم، إذا صار في انتقال سيكون هناك مساحة حقيقية لحوار وطني شامل تجتمع فيه كل القوى وعلى رأسها القوى طبعا الموجودة الآن في الأحزاب السياسية، الحراك، الحوثيين، الجيش، الشباب، وكذلك معارضة الخارج والقبائل.
I will answer your question first, Laura. Yes, the answer is yes. If there is a transition, there will be real space for a comprehensive national dialogue where all forces in Yemen will come together and join. And these will be also the political parties, whether it's the Houthiyin, the opposition inside or outside Yemen.
تتذكري في لقائنا السنة اللي فاتت وزيارتي لكثير من مراكز القرار في الولايات المتحدة كنت أطرح لهم بأن الحل يعني لليمن هو الحوار.
If you remember in our meetings last year and also on my visit to various think tanks in the US, I always proposed the idea that the solution for Yemen is dialogue.
برعاية دولية وإقليمية.
Dialogue that is sponsored by regional forces and also by international.
وهو ذات الحوار الذي نطالب فيه والذي سيكون أساس الدولة التي سنبنيها خلال الفترة الانتقالية.
And this is the same dialogue that we are demanding, and that will also form the foundation of the future state. And to the contrary, dialogue now will be much easier than it was in the past. Because people inside the tents have built this wide base of trust between the various forces. And also in all the squares around the country. Everybody has a common goal, and they will all work together to achieve this
goal.
And I'm sure that everyone was surprised to see this deeply divided society put its conflicts aside and come together to engage in this peaceful revolution. About concerning the Saudi position from Yemen.
دور السعودية في اليمن منذ سنين دور يعني لا يعني قائم على التحالف مع أشخاص وليس مع نظام أو مع دولة أو مع مؤسسة.
The Saudi role in Yemen has always been based on alliance with individuals and personalities, not with institutions or the people.
والسعودية تعمل منذ زمن على أن تبقى اليمن ضعيف وحديقتها الخليج.
And Saudi Arabia has been working for many years to ensure that Yemen remains weak and it remains its backyard.
تمنع السعودية الآن ووقوفها ضد الثورة الشبابية الشعبية أو الثورة الشبابية السلمية ناتج عن أنها تريد أنه من سيأتي بعد صالح يكون رجلها في اليمن كما كان علي صالح رجلها في اليمن.
And the Saudi reluctance to and its opposition to the revolution in Yemen and its stand against the people is the result of its search for who will come after Saleh and who will also be able to serve its interests in Yemen, just like Saleh did. And this is what we reject. And for this reason, the youth declared the establishment of the Transitional Presidential Council. And we adhere to this council as a strategic option during the transitional period. And even if Saleh were to sign the initiative, and any government that were would come after it, we're going to make sure that it will fall.
سنتعامل معها كما تعامل الشباب مع حكومة الغنوشي ومع حكومة أحمد شفيق في مصر وفي تونس.
And we will deal with it in the same manner that the youth in Tunis dealt with the government of of الغنوشي and also with the transitional government in
لأنهم
Egypt.
جزء من النظام السابق القائم على الفساد.
Because they are part of the previous regime that is based on corruption.
نحن نريد أن نبني بلدنا على أساس صحيح.
We would like to build our country on solid basis.
وهذا لن يكون بخيار تضع السعودية لأنه علي الآن عبد رب منصور سيكون رجل السعودية القادم في اليمن.
And and we will not accept the option that Saudi Arabia puts in place, and Abd Rabbo Mansour is going to be its man in Yemen.
لكن عادي خلوها عمل وهي مرحلة.
But it's if it were to be done, this would only be a transitional state or a stage.
أنا أتكلم بشفافية الشباب.
I am talking with the transparency of the youth.
دور النساء.
With respect to the role of women,
النساء كانت قبل الثورة ضحية.
Women before the revolution were victims.
كانت لديها أدوار تقليدية.
And they played traditional roles.
هذه الأدوار التقليدية تحتم عليها أنها من بيتها إلى بيت زوجها إلى قبرها.
This traditional role mandated that women move from their family's home to their husband's home to the grave.
لكن أو إنها إذا قامت بأي دور قادم فإنه يكون محصورا على النساء.
And even if she were to play a role, you know, it was restricted to the women's sphere. The revolution exposed a new role for women in Yemen.
وهي أنها قائدة.
And this is a leadership role.
قادرة على تخليص بلدها من كل الإشكالات التي كانت تعاني منها البلد أثناء ما كانت مغيبة.
And that women are able to rid the country of all the problems that the country has been suffering from.
مش مجرد يعني مطالبات في إنها تشارك سياسياً. هي الآن في على يعني بالفعل هي في مقدمة الصفوف أثناء التظاهرات.
And this is not just these are not just demands to play a political role. Women are actually at the forefront of the demonstrations.
هي في مقدمة الصفوف أثناء تقديم الخدمات الصحية.
And she, women are also on the forefront,
يعني.
You know, treating the wounded and playing a role in
that. في الأمن.
And also at the security level.
في كل شيء في كل تفاصيل الثورة.
In all the details of the revolution.
هي أهم شيء استعادة ثقتها بنفسها.
The most important thing is that women regain their own self-confidence.
واستعاد المجتمع ثقته بها.
And society has also regained its confidence in women.
الآن المجتمع ينظر إلى المرأة على غير ما كان ينظر إليها من قبل.
And now society looks at women in a totally different view.
وبالعكس إنه الآن الرجال في المجتمع اليمني ونتكلم عن وفي الثورات العربية بشكل عام يعني يشعروا بنقص. عندنا مثلا في اليمن في الساحة تشعر بنقص إن لم يذهب إلى الساحة مع زوجتها أو أمها أو أختها.
And now men in Yemeni society and also in all Arab societies where there have been revolutions, they feel incomplete if they didn't take their women, you know, wives and sisters with them to the square.
هل المرأة في أمان؟
Are women safe?
لا طبعاً.
Of course not.
وبهذا هي على قدم المساواة مع أخيها الرجل.
And in that she's in the same position that men are.
اليوم استشهدت امرأة.
Today a woman was martyred.
النساء اختطفن أثناء قيامهن بالتظاهرات.
And women are being kidnapped as they protest.
تم اعتقال العديد من النساء.
And several women have been arrested.
وكذلك الأطفال.
And also children.
المرأة والرجل والطفل والشيخ والشاب كلهم يدفعوا فاتورة عقاب جماعي.
And men and women and children and the elderly are all paying the price. They're all being collectively punished.
علي صالح يقوم بقطع خدمات كهرباء، الماء، النفط، الغاز، كل شيء.
Ali Saleh is cutting off all services from electricity to water to gas, all services.
المرأة الصامدة أمام كل هذا العقاب الجماعي.
And women are standing fast against all these all this collective punishment.
وهي ستوقف ضد أي محاولات لجر البلد نحو حرب أهلية.
And women will also stand against any efforts to drag the country into civil war.
فأتمنى أن يقف المجتمع الدولي وإخواننا وأصدقائنا هنا ضد أي حرب أهلية يريد جرنا إليها صالح.
And I wish that the international community and our friends here will stand stand by us against Saleh's effort to drag us into civil war.
وهذا لن يكون بدون الضغط الحقيقي عليه.
And this will not happen without real pressure on him.
السؤال الأخير هل شباب الثورة مؤيدين لأمريكا؟
The last question with respect to whether the youth of the revolution support America.
شباب الثورة في اليمن تحديداً. ليس لديهم أي مشكلة مع الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية.
The youth of the revolution and in Yemen in particular have no issues with the United States.
ربما شاهدت ممكن هذه المشكلة في مصر على سبيل المثال.
And maybe this problem has been encountered in Egypt for example.
لكن في اليمن بالعكس نحن على علاقة استراتيجية مع الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية ومع المجتمع الدولي بأكمله.
But in Yemen we have a strategic relationship with the US and with the international community as a whole.
شباب الثورة أكثر مرة يروحوا إلى السفارة الأمريكية ويلتقوا مع السفراء مع السفير الأمريكي.
On several occasions youth of the revolution have visited the US embassy in Yemen and have had discussions with the ambassador.
ويروحوا للاتحاد الأوروبي ويلتقوا كثير من المجتمع الدولي.
And they've also visited with the European Union and they've met several officials. And they aspire to establish a real partnership with the entire world. But they're angry. Because of the delayed international support for them.
Okay. دور الفيسبوك والتويتر كان له دور في بداية الثورة وله دور الآن وسيكون له دور مستقبلا في بناء البلد
With respect to the social media and Twitter and Facebook, it played a part in the beginning and during the revolution and in the future as well.
أخيرا سأنهي بأننا شباب الثورة في اليمن وشباب الربيع العربي نحن الآن أمامنا مرحلة جديدة قائمة على منبر أو من بوابة نوبل للسلام التي حصلنا عليها.
Lastly, I'd like to conclude by saying that the Arab youth, I mean the youth in Yemen and also the youth of the Arab Spring, they're standing on a very important platform that the Nobel Prize has opened up the door for.
نحن متأكدين من أننا قادرين على صنع السلام في العالم وليس في اليمن فقط.
We are certain that we'll be able to build peace in the entire world and not just in Yemen alone.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We've kept you too late. I just want to say one thing. Because of your courage, you have had a huge voice in Yemen. And now, through this prize, you have a huge voice on the international stage. And I assume that the next time we see you, it will not be a tent in Change Square, but perhaps in the halls of parliament, in the halls of government. But that's not a question. But thank you very, very much.
Welcome. Thank you for all of you.